Good morning friends, welcome back to our channel. So today I'll be discussing about one of the important feature of Spring Boot, that is actuator, Spring Boot actuator, and what all interview questions that I have recently encountered on Spring Boot actuator. So firstly, the question, whenever one, like, this has become a mandatory question whenever you are saying that you have worked on Spring Boot. So people are, first question that they are asking is how, what is Spring Boot actuator and what are its advantages. So coming to that, Spring Boot actuator is a sub-project of Spring Boot framework. It includes a number of additional features that helps us to monitor and manage the Spring Boot application. It contains the actuator endpoints, which we can use HTTP or JMX endpoints to manage and monitor the Spring Boot application. If you want to get production ready features in application, we should use Spring Boot application, Spring Boot actuator. Or in a simple word, Spring Boot actuator is nothing but a sub-project. When we are adding the sub-project to our project using dependency, in the form of dependency, so this sub project, which is Spring Boot actuator, has its own endpoints. It exposes endpoints, and using those endpoints we can monitor our project in live production, or in live we can monitor our production. It has different endpoints, and using those endpoints we can monitor our application. So first thing, like, how can we, first question is how can we configure, second question, how can we configure this. Let me open my one of the Spring Boot application, and in the pom.xml we just need to have this dependency of Spring Boot actuator. So this is the dependency we need, that's it. Once we have this dependency, and run the application, and in the, and now when the application starts, what are endpoints that get, that gets enabled? That would be the second question, because if you are saying you have worked on, to check if you have really worked on Spring Boot actuator configuration, you may encounter this question. So it has started. So there are different endpoints that Spring Boot actuator exposes, right? So the out of which one is health. So what are the default endpoints that get enabled here? That would be the question. So the default endpoints that get enabled are health and info. Only these two gets enabled. Apart from this, if I go with any other thing, that is let's go with env, so we'll get an exception, because by default this won't get enabled. So how can we enable this? So go to our application. Let me stop my application. Let me open application.properties, and I have commented out. So this key value page should be configured. This key should be configured saying management dot endpoints dot web dot exposure dot include star, that means all. So now let me restart the application, remove, run as Java application. So now let us see whether the environment endpoint has been enabled or not. Yes, it got enabled. Earlier you could see that there was an exception, but now it got enabled. In similar way, there can be anything, mappings also. This is one more important endpoint. I'll discuss about this. So one of the importance here is, if you, this mapping endpoint actually exposes all the endpoints that the application is that Spring Boot application, Spring Boot actuator is exposing. Now let us see and open this JSON in some good format. Let me open JSON view format. Okay, paste it. Okay, viewer, go to context, application, mappings, dispatcher, servlet. See, these are the 27 endpoints that this application is exposing. So see, if you open any out of this, this is mappings only. Okay, fine. So this is cache. This is related to cache. So this is get operation is related to heap dump, or any other thing. The get tag related to info. So this we have used actuator.info. So from here we can get that information, like what all endpoints the application is configuring. So there can be one more question, like, I don't want all the endpoints, I want only specific endpoints. In that scenario, what you can do, so you just comment out this explode include all, and just uncomment this. Just I kept it ready so that the video should be short. So in this, now I am just enabling health and mappings. So let me save this, stop the application, terminate all this, connect. You can mention any here. So you remember, by default only health and info were enabled. Now let me start the application and see whether I can access the default info endpoint or not. Come on, let me see. There is one more important interview question here as well in this thing that I recently faced and I was shocked a bit. So let me go and hit info endpoint. Boom, error, because we have not configured, so we cannot access it. Let me go with health again. Yes, health and health mappings that we have configured, so we can access only those two endpoints. So again here role based endpoints can also be configured. As I have not worked on this, I am not saying that, but there is a situation where only this particular roles people can access this actuator endpoints as well. So apart from that, there was one more question, like can we override application.properties using actuators? So yes, there is one endpoint called refresh. So using refresh endpoint and Spring Cloud combination, we can definitely do that. As I have not worked it on it and I am not explaining that thing. So that was one question. So I answered the same thing, as I haven't worked on Spring Cloud, so I'm not sure, but I know refresh will definitely do this. And one more thing is, can we update the loggers? Yes, we can update the loggers as well using a post operation, and we can do this. I have written this as well. Yeah, here. So using configuration level, we can change it to anything here. So this is at package level. So on the service package, I am changing the log level here. This is very handy when it comes into higher environments. This is very helpful, and these are the different endpoints that I was able to collect on Google's audit events. What it does, returns all the auto configuration candidates and reasons why they were or were not applied, beans, mappings, and this all things I'll be keeping this in the description as well of the video. And one more important question that I told you was, so recently I was facing one interview with Ivy Comtech. So in that interview, he was asking me what all things after banner getting printed, what all things that gets printed on the console when we start a Spring Boot application. So honestly, I was not aware of it. I know that at the end, application will be started and it will show the Tomcat. This line I was aware of. Tomcat started on port 8080. I know that, so, and it will be printed completed initialization. So only these two things I know, and I have said that. But he was expecting me all these things, like whether what will happen here. Actually, it is checking the profile. What is the profile? No profile configuration set. So falling back to default properties, Tomcat initialized on this port, starting services, starting servlet engine, and all those things he was expecting me to answer, but I couldn't answer this. So it's good to have an idea on this as well. So this was about the interview questions on Spring Boot Actuator that I have encountered in my recent interviews and felt that it might be helpful to you as well. So that's it in this video as of now, and thank you for watching this video.